Good morning. In our previous lecture, we have solved till question number 3 of exercise 13.4. Today, let's solve the remaining questions of exercise 13.4 of surface areas and volumes, which are based on surface areas of spheres and hemispheres. So, exercise 13.4, question number 4. The radius of a spherical balloon increases from 7 cm to 14 cm as air is being pumped into it. Find the ratio of the surface area of the balloon in the two cases. Now, according to the question, air is being pumped in a spherical balloon. Natural thing, the radius of the balloon will increase. Hence, we get two types of radius, that is, one is initial radius which is given as 7 cm and increased radius which is given 14 cm. So, using that two different radius, we have to find two different surface areas and then we have to find the ratio of both these surface areas. So, for solution, we have initial radius R1 equal to 7 cm and increased radius R2 equal to 14 cm. Now, surface area of balloon with initial radius A1 equal to 4 pi R1 square. Inserting the values, we get equal to 4 into 22 upon 7 into 7 into 7. Here we can cut 7, 7. So, we will remaining numbers when we multiply, we get A1 equal to 616 cm square. Next, we find the surface area of balloon with increased radius. Therefore, surface area of balloon with increased radius A2 equal to 4 pi R2 square. Value of R2 is 14 cm. Inserting the values, we get equal to 4 into 22 upon 7 into 14 into 14. Again, here we can cut 7 ones are and 7 twos are. When we multiply the remaining numbers, the product is 2464. Therefore, A2 is equal to 2464 cm square. Now, required ratio is equal to A1 upon A2. That is surface area of balloon with initial radius upon surface area of balloon with increased radius. That is equal to 616 upon 2464. On solving, we'll get equal to 1 upon 4. Therefore, the required ratio is 1:4. Next question number 5. A hemispherical bowl made of brass has inner diameter of 10.5 cm. Find the cost of tin plating it on the inside at the rate of rupees 16 per 100 cm square. Now here it is given that hemispherical bowl is made of brass whose inner diameter is given as 10.5 cm. And we have to find the cost of tin plating it on the inside at the rate of rupees 16 per 100 cm square. Again, first we find out the radius from the given diameter and then we find the cost. For solution, we have inner diameter equal to 10.5 cm. Therefore, inner radius R equal to 10.5 upon 2, that is 5.25 cm, as radius is half of diameter. Now, curved surface area of hemispherical bowl inner side equal to 2 pi r square. Inserting the values, we get equal to 2 into 22 upon 7 into 5.2 into 5.25. Again, for the solving, we will get equal to 173.25 cm². Now we have to find a cost. It is given that cost of tin plating on the inside of hemispherical ball for 100 cm square equal to rupees 16. Therefore, cost of tin plating on inside for 173.25 cm square equal to. As here we have to do the cross multiplication. You can see that we will do here the cross multiplication. So, we will get equal to 173.25 multiply by 16 upon 100. For the solving, we'll get equal to rupees 27.72. So the cost of tin plating the inner side of a hemispherical ball is rupees 27.72. Next question number 6. Find the radius of a sphere whose surface area is 154 centimeter square. Here the surface area of the sphere is given as 154 centimeter square, and using that we have to find out the radius of the sphere. For solution, let the radius of the sphere be r centimeter, because we don't know the value of r, so we are supposing it as r centimeter. Already it is given that surface area of a sphere equal to 154 centimeter square, but we know that the formula to find out surface area of the sphere is 4 pi r square. Therefore we write 4 pi r square equal to 154. For the solving, we insert the values, that is 4 into 22 upon 7 into r square equal to 154. Then we transport the numbers on the right hand side, that is we will take this on right hand side and let r square be there only. Therefore r square equal to 154 into 7 upon 4 into 22. Therefore r square equal to 12.25. Here again we can cut and then we will get the value of r square as 12.25. Therefore r equal to under root 12.25, that is equal to 3.5 centimeter. In our lower grades we already know how to find out the square root of a given number. You can use division method to find out the square. Hence the radius of the sphere is 3.5 centimeter. Next question, question number 7. The diameter of the moon is approximately 1/4 of the diameter of the earth. Find the ratio of their surface area. Now in here, diameter of the moon is given as 1/4 part the diameter of the earth, and we have to find the ratios of the surface area of the earth to the surface area of the moon. So for solution, let diameter of the earth equal to d1. We have supposed that the diameter of the earth is d1. Therefore the radius of the earth will r1 will be equal to d1 upon 2. Now it is given that the diameter of the moon equal to 1/4 or diameter of earth. Therefore diameter of the moon equal to 1 upon 4 d1. d1 is the diameter of the earth. Therefore radius of the moon r2 equal to d1 upon 2 into 4. Already d1 upon 4 is the diameter of the moon, and again we have to make half of that, that is we will get d1 upon 2 into 4, that is equal to d1 upon 8. Thus radius of the moon r2 will be d1 upon 8. Now surface area of the earth, let it be s1 equal to 4 pi r1 square. Inserting the value of r1, we get equal to 4 pi into d1 upon 2 whole square, that is we will get pi d1 square. Here we know that when we are squaring 2, that it will become 2 2's are 4, and we can cut 4 up and down, and then we will get pi d1 square. Therefore surface area of earth s1 is pi d1 square. Now surface area of the moon s2 equal to 4 pi r2 square. Inserting the values, we get equal to 4 in pi into d1 upon 8 whole square. Here you know that when we solve it further, we will get 4 pi again d1 whole square upon this 8 into 8, here you can write 64 also. So 4 1's are 4 and 4 2's are 8. So we will get d1 square upon 16. So that is equal to pi d1 square upon 16. So the surface area of the moon S2 equal to pi d1 square upon 16. Now to find the required ratio, therefore required ratio equal to S1 S2 S2. That is surface area of the earth to the surface area of the moon, that is equal to pi d1 square upon 1 is to pi d1 square upon 16. You can here cut pi d1 square same same and both are numerators, so we can cut directly. So we'll get equal to 1 upon 1 is to 1 upon 16. Further we will do the cross multiplication, means 16 will come here and 1 16 ones are 16 and 1 ones are 1. So we'll get the ratio as 16 is to 1. Therefore the required ratio is 16 is to 1. Next, question number 8. A hemispherical bowl is made of steel 0.25 cm thick. The inner radius of the bowl is 5 cm. Find the outer cut surface area of the bowl. Here, the thickness and radius of the hemispherical bowl is given and we have to find the outer cut surface area of the bowl, for which we require the outer radius of the bowl. And that easily we can get from the question, because inner radius and thickness is given. So summation of inner radius and thickness will give us the outer radius. And from that we will find the outer cut surface area of the bowl. So for solution, inner radius of the hemispherical bowl equal to 5 cm. Thickness of the hemispherical bowl is given as 0.25 cm. We know that outer radius of the bowl equal to inner radius plus thickness, that is 5 plus 0.25, that is equal to 5.25 cm. Now, outer cut surface area of the bowl equal to 2 pi r square, that is equal to 2 into 27 into 5.25 into 5.25. We can cut 7 with 5.25 and remaining numbers will multiply. So the product is equal to 173.25 cm². Thus the outer cut surface area of the hemispherical bowl is 173.25 cm². Next, question number 9. A right circular cylinder just encloses a sphere of radius r. See figure. Find the first surface area of the sphere, second cut surface area of the cylinder, third ratio of the areas obtained in 1 and 2. Here it is according to the given. First let's see the figure. That in the figure we can see that a right circular cylinder just encloses a sphere, means you can see that a sphere is enclosed, means it is from all sides the sphere is closed with a right circular cylinder, whose and the radius of the sphere is given as r. And using that we have to find the surface area of the sphere, cylindrical surface area of the cylinder, and the ratio of both. Now for solution, already it is given that the radius of the sphere is given as r, but here the radius of the cylinder and the radius of the sphere will be equal, because the circular cylinder encloses the sphere whose radius is r. Therefore radius of the cylinder equal to radius of the sphere, which is equal to r. Now height of the cylinder is nothing but the diameter of the sphere, that is equal to 2r, because diameter is twice the radius of the given shape. We can see in the figure that here this is the radius of the, sorry, this is the diameter of the cylinder. Radius is nothing but the height of the cylinder. Here you can see, here this is nothing but the height of the cylinder, which is nothing but diameter of the sphere, and diameter of the sphere is given as 2 times r, that is 2r. Now question number 1, we find the surface area of the sphere A1 equal to 4 pi r square. It will remain the same because radius is not given, it is given as r only. So the surface area of the sphere A1 equal to 4 pi r square. Now we find the cut surface area of the cylinder, that is question number 2. Let it be A2 equal to 2 pi r h. Inserting the values equal to 2 pi into r into 2r, because radius is given as r only and height is given as 2r. Solving we get curved surface area of the cylinder A2 equal to 4 pi r square. Now we have to find the ratio of both, that is required ratio equal to A1 is to A2, that is equal to 4 pi r square is to 4 pi r square, that is equal to 1 is to 1. Hence the ratio of surface area of the sphere is to curved surface area of the cylinder is 1 is to 1. Dear students, please copy all these in our regular CW. Thank you.